Hello everyone. In this video, we'll talk about one topic from bioinformatics, and this is especially important for aspirants who are going to give GATB 2021, because bioinformatics is a new addition and you guys don't have a clue how to prepare for that. And these videos would be really helpful for you. Now, in this quick revision session, we would be talking about CATH database. But before that, let me tell you, many of you guys are kind of confused right now how you can prepare for several entrance examinations like GATB, like JAM, etc. So let me tell you that Unacademy is your one-stop destination where educators help you to analyze trends and prepare accordingly for this particular exams. Now, what about the financial aspect? Financial aspect is kind of taken care of because the prices are low, and also Unacademy announces 10 lakhs worth of fellowship in August. You can avail the fellowship, you just have to give the exam for that. So here is Space Jam Accelerate Test, 8th August at 11 a.m. You just need to enroll for this test, try to give the test, and if you are the winner, you can get the whole 1 year subscription for free. Just use my code AP10 to get a free access. So what you need to do in short is to download the Unacademy app, click on the link which is given in the description, and then use my code AP10 to get a free access and give the test. So give this test and you might get a scholarship. Now let's back to our own discussion. So we are going to talk about CATH database, which deals with protein. And CATH stands for class, architecture, topology, and homology. We would understand what does that mean in context of a protein structure. But overall, CATH is a protein structure classification database. Now, the most important thing about CATH is you can get information about evolutionary relationship of protein domains. So this is super important when we are talking about CATH. Now, just a brief history. CATH was created in 1990s by Professor Christine Orengo's group, and it is maintained by University College London. Now, CATH get all the information regarding protein sequence from PDB. Now, it get the protein sequence from PDB and then add a layer of information with that sequences. So only structures which are having a resolution 4 Armstrong or even better than that are taken in CATH database, and several layers of information are added. And now we're going to look at what are the layers of information we are talking about. So first of all, these proteins are classified and grouped in different classes. So first one in the hierarchy would be class. This gives us an overall idea about the secondary structure content in the protein, whether our protein of interest contains alpha helix, beta pleated sheet, or a combination of both. All of these things can be understood from this hierarchy. So there would be three major classes in the CATH database. So it can be either grouped or either it can be situated either in alpha helixes or in beta pleated sheet or in alpha beta both, any of these categories. The second level is architecture, which is information on secondary structure arrangement in a three-dimensional space, and this is the basis of classification. There could be beta barrel, beta sandwich, or beta roll, these kind of aspects. I mean, there are almost 32 architectures reported in this particular CATH databases. Next comes topology. So topology is an information on how secondary structure elements are connected and arranged in a three-dimensional space. So the classification basis is on three-dimensional topology. And lastly, homology. So it's based on evolutionary relationship. Like, assignments are made if the domains are having any evolutionary relatedness. So these are four classification basis used by CATH. So this is how CATH's website look like. You can see the interface is pretty simple. Now at the middle of the screen, you can see it talks about protein evolution, protein function, 3D structure, etc. So we need to go right now to CATH's website to understand what's there. So here is CATH website. So you can see there is a search bar. Here you can enter any protein name, or you can simply click on the search bar to go to this page. Here you can also enter a protein sequence. That's super important. So let's say you have a protein sequence in mind. You can paste that protein sequence here. So in our case, I have copied one protein sequence, and I have copied this protein sequence here, and then I'll hit search. So after hitting search, you can see our job is submitted. Now they are going to give us the result within a few moments. So already with that particular sequence information, this database found 163 matches. In which category? To look for the structural domains present in our protein. So it tells us about the structural domain that is present. And it matches with 19 functional families, right? So we can go to the results, and here you see there is a E value. So again, you know E value is what? We have already encountered E value in terms of BLAST. Lower the E value, better it is, right? So let's say we click on the structure which was in the top of the list. You can see already it gives four levels, CATH, right? Class, architecture, topology, homology, right? So already it tells you that, okay, in this particular protein structure, there is quite a lot of alpha and beta, both these things are there. So let me zoom it for you. Now in architecture, it tells you alpha beta barrel. In topology, it tells you team barrel. And lastly, in homology, it says alanine racemes, right? So these information is provided in CATH. Now you can also see the domain. Overall visualization of the domain is provided. You can zoom and see. Later on, it gives you a bunch of information about superfamily, functional family, etc. Also notice that this particular database is cross-referenced with UniProt knowledge base, right? So all these informations are obtained from CATH. Also, you can see the PDB structure is provided, right? All the links regarding PDB structure is provided with this database. So all of these databases are highly interlinked, and we understand what information we can possibly get from this particular database. So overall, if we want to determine what type of structures are present in our protein, what type of domains are present in a protein, and we want to talk about evolutionary relationship, then this is a good database. So here is the important points regarding this particular topic. So you need to understand what is CATH. We already discussed that part. CATH stands for class, architecture, topology, and homology. Four bases of classification in this particular database. So overall, CATH database provides us hierarchical classification of protein domains based on folding patterns, and it also gives us information about evolutionary relationship. It obtains all the structural information from protein data bank and then annotate it with several layers of information. So that's all about CATH. You can revise many other topics regarding GATB 2021 by using my playlist. So don't forget to check out. And if you like this video, give it a quick thumbs up. Tune in, let me know in the comment how you like my videos. Okay, you can follow me in Instagram or Facebook, and please comment and tell me whether you like these videos or not. Thank you.